On the Morning Groove this morning is a phenomenal Atlantan, a phenomenal woman doing some major things, gracing TV screens worldwide these days, Yovanna Momplaisir. Did he get it right?
He was close.
You got it perfect.
Oh,
all right.
Man. Look at Art Terrell. You go Art.
Yeah.
You go Art.
What does that mean, by the way?
Mon plaisir. It means my pleasure.
Oh, I love
you
it.
You didn't know?
One more time. One more time into that mic. What does it mean?
It means my pleasure.
All right. All right. And that
is French. Yes, it is French, darling.
You know what? That fits you.
Oui, oui.
That fits you.
It's French.
That does fit you. All right. So Real Housewives of Atlanta, you know, it begs a question. This is your first season.
Second season.
Her second season.
How could you forget?
Well, you know, come on now.
Right. She had a mad introduction, yo.
Okay.
At
second
the table.
Season.
I remember that.
How did we get here? How did you become a part of this thing?
Well, Bravo reached out to me. I talked to them for a little while. I tested with the cast, and I guess I did well enough to come back and then come back again.
Okay. Were you friends with one person or another person that may have put your name in the pot to be a part of this?
Well, I had some acquaintances with some of the women in the group, and then I got introduced to Nene. We established a friendship, connected, and yeah, the rest is history.
Okay.
And, you know, she came in with a bang, and when she was introduced to, you know, on the show, I knew you weren't going to be no punk. And this time around, we really got to see who you are and what you're made of. And it's got to be hard to deal with these women because they have a history of, like, ganging up on a certain person. There's a serious double standard that drives me nuts.
I'm glad you see it, too.
Yes, yes. I don't want to say it, but Stevie and Ray could both see it. it's that. I'm telling you, it's that bad. Let's talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, there's a seriously double standard amongst the ladies in the group, and it's very clear that these ladies operate off of two different sets of rules.
Mm-hmm.
They have a set of rules of how they can function, and then a set of rules of how the new girls can function.
Exactly.
Something as simple as arguments. They decipher who they want to forgive sooner than others. Mm-hmm. They can have a situation, talk it through, and be best of buddies, but let the new girl come in the circle, try to argue with them. Oh, you're trying to put them out the group.
Yeah.
You don't even feel
no,
with
seriously.
Them. Are you saying the Real Housewives of Atlanta is a gang?
Look, they come across that way. Okay, I'll give you an example. Okay, last season, there was a situation where Eva was confiding in Nene. Mm-hmm. And she told Nene when she was about to talk to her, she said, I don't want this to be recorded. Turn your mic off. Take your mic off. Mm-hmm. Nene did not do that. Mm-hmm. So the whole conversation was picked up, right? Okay, no problem. They got over that. They squashed it. Now, fast forward to this season, and the whole snake gate goes down, in which there was no snake, but we'll get to that later. But the whole snake gate goes down, and it's like, who recorded who or who did it? Oh, she did it? Basically, she ain't been here long enough to do that.
Right,
she's a newcomer.
Right.
Wow.
You have no room, no space to do that. Like, it's like, come on,
they can
ladies.
They throw shade, and when they throw shade, it's considered fun shade. If I throw shade, oh, we want to fight you.
Yeah.
That's clearly a double standard.
Wow.
We could go on for days about the double standards. Now, can we talk? Because I've got to get this off my chest. What annoyed me the most about, quote, snake gate? It's like you had one culprit, Cynthia. She was talking trash about Nene behind Nene's back. But when it was introduced that somehow they thought you had something to do with it, it was like the focus of the real problem was lost. It was like, let's go after the new girl.
Right.
Who's Snakegate? Who recorded it? You did it. No one recorded it.
Right. And this is where the entire country, like, went crazy when Nene in her confessional, when she said, is Yovanna the one with information? And she said, yes. I'm not denying that because I did admit early in the season that
you knew,
receipts, right?
Yeah.
Yes, I told her that Cynthia was talking trash about her. But as you just said, at no point did anybody care to know what that information was. It was just, oh, you're the one with the receipts. What
exactly.
is the receipts? And they turned that. And we've talked about this, of course, and Nene has cleared this up. The wrong verbiage was used with the whole audio recording situation. Receipts don't correlate to audio recording.
No, they don't.
It could be proof of a conversation that we had.
Exactly.
As far as where we had the conversation. And so it didn't make sense that it took that wind, but no one ever focused on what was actually said.
Another thing that blew my mind was literally the gang activity when they approached you? And it was like, at first, it was like 3-on-1. I think it was Kenya, Candy, and Portia. Uh-huh. And then the whole room.
Yeah.
But you held your own.
Oh, 100%.
You didn't pop not one sweat bead. 100%. Like, you held your own.
Because I said what I said, and I had said it multiple times at that mm-hmm. point. And so I had got to the point where I was frustrated. It's like, my word should be my word. Do you have any proof proving otherwise? Mm-hmm. Then if you don't, get out my face.
Right.
And so
right.
that's when it blew up, and then I went in on Portia, and then... And that's the other thing I'm saying.
Yeah.
So the double standard exists. I wasn't the first person to talk about her
No.
significant other and the rumors that were going on about him sleeping with animals.
And they're still talking about
him.
No. I want to say this. No. So Nene brought it, listen to this though. Nene brought it up first, okay? Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I think Candy referenced it. Marlo talked about it as well. But they all kumbaya and they besties. But
yeah.
As I'm soon as you, because
yeah.
I said it.
Yeah. That's how they, that's what I'm saying.
Wait a minute. Wait,
double standards.
Did you see a movie or something?
No,
with
it, was just,
animals?
It was
just repeated
a
what was in the blogs.
Yeah, it was
I just
repeated
what I saw in the blogs.
Yeah, it was a
and
rumor.
And they did as well.
Now, mm-hmm. you know these blogs ain't loyal.
No, but the point is, they all had been repeating it. But mm-hmm. as soon as she repeated it, it was a problem.
All
oh,
head
how
loose.
Dare she? She ain't been here long uh-huh. enough type thing.
Let me ask you this, because you said you held your own. Did that make them mad? Did they come off like you're supposed to just cower?
I think so.
Absolutely.
So it made them mad that you held your own.
Yeah,
correct.
Because that's when it elevates and people are getting up and they want to mm-hmm. start walking towards you because it's like the intimidation isn't working. Because
I was still sitting down.
Yeah, she never lost a cool.
Right.
Never lost a
you
cool.
You're going to make
right?
me watch this show.
You've been missing out, brother.
I know. I feel some kind of way when I'm alone watching Housewives by myself. I don't know what to do about it.
I'm telling you, it is.
Get you, girl. I have to watch it with you.
It's a lot of beautiful women on the show. You shouldn't feel that
Trying
bad.
Trying not to get in trouble, bro.
Definitely a crooked dynamic. But speaking of Candy, what's the issue with Candy?
And see, this is the thing. I don't have an issue with any of the women. Mm-hmm. They have an issue with me.
Mm-hmm.
The Candy has earned the title Salt Bae, a.k.a. KMZ, because she likes wow. to insert herself in
Listen,
everyone's salt. Situation.
She has become
that
person.
And throw extra seasoning on it, making yeah. things worse than what man. They are. And so after I've come out and I've explained the whole audio fiasco, done multiple interviews, even Nene clearing it up, she still is doing interviews as if there is mm-hmm. one. Mm-hmm. And my problem with that is I have a reputation. I have businesses right. to uphold. And talking about me in a negative light just doesn't sit well with me because she actually dealt with something similar a few mm-hmm.
yes.
Years ago.
With Portia. And
with,
yeah,
yeah. Yeah, with the whole sex dungeon yeah. thing. She was upset with them because she was saying that they were tarnishing her brand mm-hmm. and that it was just messed up. And so I'm like, you should be able to relate to what I'm saying.
Yes.
So that's my issue with her.
Let's go down the list.
Your issue with
yeah.
Portia. Is this a result of you saying that he was
well,
sleeping with the...
Well, once again, I'll say this.
You know what? I'm done.
Look.
I ain't saying he did it. I'm just saying that was a bad...
Once again, I don't have an issue with Portia. Portia has an issue with me. She's mm-hmm. had an issue with me since we were 18 years old, back mm-hmm. when we used to do music videos together.
Wow.
Back when she, you know, what's the cartoon character Popeye's girlfriend's name? What's
Olive
that?
Oil.
Olive Oil.
Back when she used to look like Olive.
You know,
oh,
okay.
My
you
God.
Know, so, you know, she doesn't like to talk about them days when she did videos. She tries to mm-hmm. act like she doesn't remember me mm-hmm. from those videos. Mm-hmm. But the issue I feel like she has is because, yes, I took a jab at her man. And like I said, I'm just repeating what I saw in the blog.
Yeah.
So wait
yeah.
a minute. I mean, if y'all were doing videos back then, uh-huh. you had to be pretty close as far
well,
as...
Well, we weren't close, but we ran
in
the same circles.
They
yeah.
definitely knew each other.
I mean, she remembers Trillville, mm-hmm. some cut. I know she don't like to remember that she did that oh, video, yeah, but that's yeah, how she, we got our start.
Now, of course, she was in that video. That's where...
We were side by side. Girl.
I'm done.
What
y'all
is
so crazy.
What's up?
What's the sound effect again?
Oh, what is it?
What's up?
Y'all gotta play that. It's AM. We play R&B. My bad.
No, we might be able to pull that off,
man.
And maybe at least a little instrumental bed, at least. Oh my gosh! So, what's been your? I mean, I could go on for days, but what's been your overall experience with the ladies and the show in general?
Well, it's definitely been a roller coaster ride, I'll say for sure. You know, trying to decipher between what's real, what's fake.
Mm-hmm. Right.
These are a very strong group of women, but they met their match. You know,
yeah.
I grew up as a middle child, so I always grew up having to fight
for everything
defend myself.
You are.
Right.
Middle child power, honey. I'm right
so
there.
You,
with
already,
you
know.
Already know.
So it is what it is. I understand it comes with the territory, but like I said, they picked the right one.
Oh, yeah.
I got the right one. I said what I said.
Yeah. You know, what I really like about you is the fact that you do bring a little bit of Atlanta to the show.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you are here. You did high school here.
Mm-hmm.
You had businesses here.
With the colleges.
Right.
Clark.
You know, so, I mean, you bring that to the show, and that's a good thing because it is real. Housewives of Atlanta. Now,
correct.
Whether you're a housewife or not, I don't think you are because you own a number of businesses. And talk about those businesses for a second and tell everybody what you do when you're not on camera being fabulous and snatching people's wigs
right.
and all of that stuff.
Absolutely. So my foundation, Stop the Traffic, that's the most important one that I've recently launched not too long ago, which brings awareness to human sex trafficking in Atlanta. I have my fashion boutique, Momplaisir by Yovanna. My husband and I, we run a business, Momplaisir Consultants, where we do consulting in the telecom world.
Mm-hmm.
But going back to the foundation, like a lot of these things are things that Bravo doesn't highlight. And so I'm grateful that you guys have given me a chance to come on here and talk about it today.
Yeah.
But Atlanta is the number one hub in this country for human sex trafficking.
Yep.
Yes, it is.
And there is no way that I was going to have this platform and not shed light and bring awareness to it. In the past, 5 years alone, Atlanta has gone from being a $232 million a year business in the human sex trafficking field to $290 million.
That's crazy.
And unfortunately, that's more than the illegal gun and drug trade combined. And it's gotten to where it has gotten because people in those industries are now realizing that there's more money and it's more lucrative to get in this business for the simple fact that unlike drugs, a human can be sold over and over and over again. And so, I think it's important to educate people on a consistent basis about what things they should be looking for when it comes to sex trafficking.
And what steps are you taking in that educational process?
Yeah, well, just recently we've been going to high schools and colleges. We went to South Cobb High School 2 weeks ago. Last week, I did a panel at KSU, Kennesaw State University, and I was just honored. I don't know if you guys know,
I
was honored. Thank you. At the state capitol with a United Nations Award.
Let's hello.
Get there. Okay.
Worldwide,
not too
baby.
Many people
worldwide.
Are honored with a global award
for
their
that.
Efforts. Oh,
Nini
no, none of them got that.
None of them,
none of them
do.
Got that. None of them
none
do.
Of
I can tell
do.
You that. So it's just great to be recognized and commended for the work that I am doing because I'm serious. This isn't a fad.
Mm-hmm.
You guys will hear me talking about it next month, the month after, next year, 10, 15 years, until human sex trafficking is no more.
Boots on the ground.
Right. Yes.
Yeah. They might be Manola Blahniks or something like that.
But they on the ground.
Boots are on the ground.
On no, that's right.
What's something you can tell young ladies to look out for? Oh, man, I mean... people are people. They'll snatch whoever.
Oh, absolutely.
For the money.
And I'm so glad you asked that question. So there's a lot of falsehoods and myths out there as to far as what human sex trafficking is.
Mm-hmm.
Most people think, oh, a big buff guy in a white van. Oh, no. Human sex trafficking victims aren't always taken by someone that they don't know. Unfortunately, human sex trafficking is now infiltrating wealthy suburbs. You could be trafficked by a family member, a friend, a coworker, an employer, a religious leader, a would-be boyfriend or girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
They now have recruiters that look just like your kids,
right.
That could be convincing them that this lifestyle is cool, and then when they get into it, they don't really understand what it is. And so making sure that people are conscious that the person could look just like you or me, or it could be a child. I mean, sex trafficking has no color, no age, no gender, and it starts as young as 12 years old. So in addition, I want to point out that there's a lot of intentional and unintentional contributors. I don't know if you guys know this, but sex traffickers lurk on gaming system platforms. You ever heard of Roblox?
Mm-mm.
My nieces and nephews play Roblox.
All the time.
Yes.
My daughter does, too.
Yes. Oh, they go into the messaging system, and they're sending them messages as if, you know, they're the same age. Yeah. Your kid is going to think that.
That's how it starts. Yeah.
But they're not. Right. But they're not. So making sure as a parent that you're monitoring what your kids are doing. Never meet anyone alone for the first time. Mm-hmm. Never enter anyone's car that you don't know for the first time. When you are going to your vehicle at night, make sure you have a security guard or someone escort you. And the biggest thing, we get so caught up in our phones where we're always looking down. We're not paying attention to our surroundings.
What's around us.
So a recruiter or a sex trafficker is paying attention to that, and you're their first victim.
Takes 2 seconds to snatch you up. If that.
Yeah, that's powerful.
Yeah, absolutely.
I'm happy you're operating in that area because I can see that you have a lot of knowledge on it.
And passions,
When we actually get deeper into that, I would like for you to come back if you can to, you know, help us out with that topic.
I would love to.
Switch back. Let's go back to that show that you're on.
Oh, we going back to the drama? Y'all like that.
So you're operating in this environment, like... And you've been at it for a couple of years now. Is there anything you would change about your Real Housewives of Atlanta experience?
Would I change anything? No, I'm the type of person, I live in the moment. I feel like every situation and everything that happens to you is for a reason, and you are where you are because of those experiences. It's either a lesson or a blessing. So, no.
Okay.
I wouldn't.
So, how many more episodes do we have left in this season? And have we reached the peak of drama, or is there more to
come? Oh, no,
there's
definitely more, so y'all have to stay tuned. I think there's at least, like, 10 more before the reunion time comes. So you guys, stay tuned.
You
keep watching.
So I'm thinking, right, you said they got a way that they treat the newcomers. So let's say, bam, couple years down the road, you done been in there, and now you wanted to... What's up?
You're in the gang.
You're
not being initiated. You're in the gang now.
Yeah, she needs a peach.
When they bring somebody new, do you remember and say, nah, let's not do it like that? Or do you be like, well, this is where we at?
Oh, no, absolutely. You remember. Mm-hmm. You remember where you came from. You remember how you were treated. And you make it fair.
Right.
Because they were all in my shoes at one point before. So, yeah.
Honey, at one point, Portia couldn't even stand in the same room with Candy. Like, it was that bad.
Yeah.
So it is, like, I'm telling you, it's a really, oh, man, it's an evil dynamic that goes on that show. It's just crazy. So last night's episode, which will be this weekend, what happens? Do you know what happened, or do you guys know in advance the episodes that are coming down?
I haven't seen it, so I'm not sure. So I don't want to speak on that, but it's going to turn up. Definitely a little bit more. So,
oh, gosh,
it's going to turn up.
And you got to start watching because you said you don't watch. You got to start watching.
I'm in there. I'm a comedian. If I watch, I'm only watching with a jokester's pen. So I'm trying not to be that guy. But gave me some incentive. I got to see this.
It's crazy though because this season it seemed like Nene was public enemy number one. Like, whenever she came into the room, it was just like, oh, my God, like, why does she have to? But they were so easily, you know, like, affected by what she did and moved. Like, it's like once she stirred that pot, it was like nothing else had to happen.
And that's what I'm saying. I feel like they do her dirty, too. Back to the double standards. Some people, they choose to forgive sooner than others. Like, what she did last season, I mean, that doesn't equate to not talking to the lady for 6 months on end. Like, for instance, I mentioned this in another interview, but between, who was it? I think it was... Yeah, it was Portia and it was Eva. And Eva was talking about Portia's C-section scar.
Yes.
And talking about her man as well.
Yes.
And you would think that she would obviously take offense to that.
Mm-hmm.
Within like 30 minutes after they talked it out, they were cool.
Mm-hmm.
So why y'all still mad at Nene? I mean, they've gotten over it since, you know, but you see my point?
Yeah. And can we just note that Eva has amnesia a lot? That girl will say some stuff, and then I didn't say that. And then Bravo's so messy, they'll just run it back.
You did actually say it. Here it is.
Right.
Want to hear it? Here it go.
I got a guy out the loop question. So what goes on Housewives? Does that happen in real life with women, and that's what the allure is? That's why women love it? Or are they watching like, that's what I wish I would have did? Like, what's the connection? Is it real life happening?
Is it real life or is it on 10 by the time it gets to? Right.
Oh, no, it's definitely real scenarios for sure. Mm-hmm. I mean, what you see is what you get. Mm-hmm. Of course, there's, you know, editing and producers that, you know, to amplify it, to heighten it. But no, it's definitely real situations that I think women across America can watch and relate to.
So, like, relate, like... are y'all like the superhero versions of women in these situations? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'd like to think so.
Yeah, they are.
Absolutely.
You know
what
I mean? Look at her. Don't she look like a superhero?
I went to go get the good water for the superhero.
Not the good water. You did go get the good water. He went all the way upstairs for you.
I want to do some rapid fire real quick before you get out of here. Sure. And just give me the name of the housewife that it fits. Most jealous.
Go ahead and say it, girl.
Y'all gonna make me start some stuff. Well, all right. I'll say Portia.
Okay.
Best personality.
Best personality.
Supposed to be rapid fire.
Go ahead and say you.
Yeah, you could say you.
Okay,
yeah.
I'll say
Come on now. We need to go to the judges.
We can go to the judges. I would say you and what's the young lady's name? She's always so bubbly. And
Tanya.
Yeah, okay. I would say her and Tanya, definitely. Yeah.
Meanest person.
I would say the meanest is probably Kenya.
Okay. Coolest person.
My opinion has changed within the past couple of days. Right. But the coolest person, I'm going to say me.
Okay.
Nice.
Second coolest person.
Look at you.
Second
coolest person, Nene.
Okay.
Fakest.
Oh, dang.
Jump on in.
The fakest?
Yeah.
Candy.
Oh, boy, that hurts. That's one of my favorite housewives. Okay. The person you would hang out with on a regular basis.
Nene.
Okay.
I like that.
I mean, that's the one I do hang out with on a regular basis. Yeah. I don't hang out with the other ones.
Yeah. Right. Anything else?
I think
the person on the show who you think is most likely to try you to get these hands.
Portia.
Oh, yeah. Without a doubt.
She want them. She want them. She want it. She want it.
And so you ain't going to get snatched up like Kenya got snatched up.
No, not at all.
Nah.
Not at all. Not at all.
There will be no running down the alley behind Yovanna. That ain't happening.
Oh, man.
Love
this is phenomenal. Make sure you check out Real Housewives of Atlanta. Look out for our girl, Yovanna Momplaisir.
There you go.
It's all about the pleasure, baby.
Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.